Hello guys and welcome to CryptoBull. In this video I'm going to show you 7 different applications which you can use to track your cryptocurrency portfolios. If you are having more than 10 cryptocurrencies, this is very important to have this type of application. And in this video I will show you some applications which you can use on your mobile devices, like on Android or on iOS systems, and some which you can use for desktop. So as some of these applications will allow you to create a watch list, which means that you can create a watch list of different cryptocurrencies to see the price changes of these particular cryptocurrencies, and most of these applications will allow you to create watch lists of your cryptocurrencies. This means that you will be able to add transactions if you have bought or if you are buying some different cryptocurrencies. This will be added to your cryptocurrency portfolio and also to the total price, and you will be able to track all your portfolio, whether it you have like 100 cryptocurrencies, whether you have 400, like I have over 400 different cryptocurrencies, and for me this is the must. And one thing is that you will not have to add your cryptocurrencies to any of these applications which I will show you in this video. You will just have to record your transactions which you have made. For example, if you buy Bitcoin, you are just registering that you have bought this much Bitcoin for this much price, and this will straight away be added to your portfolio, and you will be able to see prices or track prices. You are adding just at prices of your cryptocurrencies which you have. As I'm using many different cryptocurrency exchanges, I am registered with almost every cryptocurrency exchange out there. My cryptocurrencies are all over the place. They are on different cryptocurrency exchanges, they are on different wallets, they are on different hardware wallets. So for me to know even what I have and what cryptocurrencies do I owe, for me this is the must to have a portfolio tracker. And if you have the same issue and if you are holding more than 10 cryptocurrencies, I believe that this is why you have searched for this video, because you are just starting to lose track of your portfolio or your cryptocurrencies. Okay guys, let's get into it, and let's start with first is mobile application, and this is Blockfolio. This is one of the most popular ones because this has been created long time ago, guys, and this is for mobile users. If you are using Android phones or iOS phones, then Blockfolio is for you guys. As you see, get up, and here you can get application or Blockfolio downloaded to your phone on App Store for iOS users or for Apple users, and on Google Play you can download for Android device users. So Blockfolio is one of the oldest, and this is very good tracker. Next one, which is very similar and which will not be a big difference to Blockfolio, is Delta, and this is delta.app. If you go into URL delta.app, similar here, Delta Investment Tracker, one app to track all your investments fully free. So these first two, they are free, allow to track your portfolios. You simply add transactions which you have made. I will demonstrate you how you can add it a little bit later in this video, guys. But in general, these are for mobile users, and these two first ones don't have desktop versions, as many of you are probably using mobile phones. However, I am IT guy myself, I am programmer, and I never use any applications which are related to my finances or trading on my mobile application. For that, I have dedicated computer with increased security. Just to let you know that personally, I'm not using mobile applications for no financial activities, whatever I do. Next one is Alt Pocket, and this is one which is also very easy. I will show you how you can add transaction. For example, if you are holding 10 different cryptocurrencies and one of them could be ADA or anything like that, all you need to do is log in into Alt Pocket. As you can see, guys, I am now logged in. I just created a new account for this video. You will be redirected to page like this. If you click here on portfolio, this is what you will see. And there you will see this wall, and here you have holdings. If you scroll down, you currently don't have holdings. As you see, I haven't added any holdings here. And then we have transactions, and transactions is what you are doing with your cryptocurrencies. Whenever you buy, for example, new cryptocurrency, you are adding a transaction and it will be registered in your holdings. Or whenever you are selling, you can also add a transaction, how much you have sold of that particular cryptocurrency, and this will be also registered in your holdings. And this is just to track your portfolio. Let's do it, guys, and I will show you how you can do it. Let's go into holdings, for example, scroll a little bit down, and here you in the right bottom corner, you will see this plus sign, add holdings transaction, guys. And here, add manual transaction, just click in there. And here, for example, what do you want? For example, choose type of transaction. This means that whether you just have bought, buy transaction, this will be whether you have bought, for example, ADA, Cardano, or for example, Bitcoin or any other cryptocurrency, or sold, or you have transferred it somewhere else, guys. But usually you will be adding buy or sell. So for example, let's say that I have bought 0.1 Bitcoin. So here, choose coin. Here we are typing in ticker or Bitcoin. You can type it however you want. You search for it and click Bitcoin. So this transaction is in relation to Bitcoin. Then scroll a little bit down and here you will see coin. And here exchange. This allows you to pick exchange on which you have bought this cryptocurrency, because it will allow you to track the price of that exchange, because on different cryptocurrency exchanges, prices for different cryptocurrencies can be different for one from another. So let's say that you have bought this cryptocurrency on Binance, or I have bought this cryptocurrency on Binance cryptocurrency exchange. As I am from Europe, I'm using Binance, or you if you have bought it on Coinbase or KuCoin, for example, you can type it or search it here, guys. And then you type in here what you have used to buy it. Let's say I have used Tether or USDT to buy this Bitcoin. I type it in here and this is per coin 3,702. It will find you price straight away. As you can see, I typed in Bitcoin and I typed in Tether USDT and it found price straight away in relation to Binance. And then quantity, how much I have bought, let's say 0.1 Bitcoin. Here is the date when you have done this transaction, because it will start tracking the price from the date which you will add here, guys. For example, if I have bought it yesterday, I could add here 10th of June or any other date. So it will start tracking my portfolio, or particular this buy order which I did this transaction 0.1 Bitcoin from yesterday or from any other date where I bought. So it will be calculating my profit or loss depending on date where I have bought this cryptocurrency. But if you already have created one of these types of portfolio trackers, then obviously you will be adding a new transaction whenever you will be buying or whenever you will be selling a new cryptocurrency. And here you can add note, for example, I bought it on Binance or whatever you want, guys. So you can track also where you have this particular cryptocurrency which you have bought. And then after you just click on add, and here you will see view all transactions, and here your transaction is registered. And if you would like to see your portfolio now, this so this transaction sees all your general transactions, whatever you have, and I'm showing just for you on this example, because this works similar to all these applications, whether it's a mobile application. So you, if you are new, because for some of new cryptocurrency investors, this might be new concept, how to create a portfolio and why you have these transactions, for example, here. So that's why I'm doing a little bit deep dive into this, how to add transactions and meaning of these transactions whenever you are buying or selling. So transactions is just what you are doing, but you are not actually buying or selling Bitcoin here. This is just data which you are collecting, and you are showing this particular application what you have, whether you have bought, whether you have sold. For example, next day you might buy again Bitcoin, so you do exactly the same. You click here on buy, you click here on buy on this plus sign and click again on adding a new cryptocurrency. And again, let's say we bought Bitcoin, but this day, for example, we bought again, we used USDT to buy this Bitcoin or Tether to buy this Bitcoin, and this day we bought, for example, 0.2 Bitcoin. We bought today 0.2 Bitcoin, let it stay like that, and let's click add and view transactions, and here you will see two transactions. But if you go into holdings, usually you refresh if you are using Alt Pocket, because then it shows you whatever you have, guys. And here you will see this one transaction, how much Bitcoin you have. As you can see, quantity of Bitcoin, I have 0.3. The coin which we are adding or added is this Bitcoin, as you see. The price currently is 37,000. We have bought or we have in our portfolio 0.3 Bitcoin, and change in last 24 hours is 0.98 cents minus 0.98 cents. This means that we have lost on our portfolio in last 24 hours this number. So as if you will have more coins than that or more cryptocurrencies than that, then you will see here all your calculation. And in transactions, let's add another one. Let's say we bought ADA, okay, let's say Cardano ADA we bought, and we, on exchange which we used was Binance, okay, let's add the Binance, and we bought, for this is current price, we bought 1000 of ADA. Here date, for example, we bought it today, so price would be current day's price 1.51, or if you have managed to buy it cheaper, you can add there price manually and click on add and view transactions. And here you will see also these transactions that you have bought ADA. And if you will go to your holdings, you will see here in your total, this is your total, this is total amount for your Bitcoin, which is 0.3 Bitcoin which you have, and 1000 ADA coins which you have. This is your total amount, and here at the top you will be able to see whether your portfolio is in loss in current situation. As you can see, because of, I calculated some yesterday's price, my portfolio is in loss minus 11%, guys. So I hope that you get the idea how this works. But here also on Altcoin Pocket, just to point it out, while we are here on Alt Pocket, you can go and track other people, what other people are doing, and you can follow other people, what cryptocurrencies they have and what transactions, whether they, when they are selling, when they are buying. And to do so, you go here on top lists, and here best performance, and if you click there, you will see users with best performance. As you can see, this, for example, Chief PM in last 30 days, his portfolio is up 656%. And if you would like to see his coins, you just click into him and scroll down, and here you will see what cryptocurrencies he is holding, performance in last 24 hours. Or for example, for Solana, as you can see he's holding, you can click into it and you can see transactions which he have made on this particular cryptocurrency, when he was buying, when he was selling, and so on and so forth. So yes guys, this is how you use these applications. But now let's continue with next one, and next one is coin tracking, and this is more serious application where you can have free version. Obviously, for simply tracking your portfolio, you can have free version, but here you can also prepare your tax reports, or this is very useful to preparing PDFs, CSV files for your tax reports, and to track your all whenever you are buying cryptocurrencies or whenever you are selling cryptocurrencies. But obviously this application is more advanced, and if you would be thinking about taxes or anything like that, guys, that would obviously require much more money. If you are trading just couple thousand dollars, it doesn't really matter. And me myself, I'm not doing this type of tax reporting or tax tracking, as I don't really want to show my data to any of these centralized applications or store it in their databases about me, just for future purposes. So what I'm doing is I'm using these simple tracking applications, guys. So next one, like I mentioned, this is coin tracking. If you are interested in more advanced versions, this is also paid version. And next one is Messari, guys. This is also more kind of advanced application, similar to TradingView, for example, or CoinMarketCap. But if you are interested only in creating watch list of your cryptocurrencies, you click here on this first tab, Messari.io. As you see, very first one is watch list. Track the assets that matter to you, sign up for free or log in to create a watch list, or sign up for free you can do and log in if you already have your watch list. And next one is well known to many of you who are more in cryptocurrency space. This is CoinGecko. You can also store your different cryptocurrencies here if you go, for example, on CoinGecko. But this is not like creating your portfolio, but this is more like creating your watch list. So, for example, you would like to create a watch list of different cryptocurrencies which are here, but this will not allow you to track the total amount of your cryptocurrencies which you have. For example, you have bought ADA, you have bought Solana, you have bought Tron and other different cryptocurrencies. It will not give you the total amount or plus or minus or loss or profit or loss of your portfolio. This will allow you to track particular cryptocurrencies. For example, if I would like to track Uniswap, I just click this star sign, add to my portfolio, and when I go to my portfolio, guys, scrolling up here, you can see here is portfolio. As you can see here, guys, click on this tab, portfolio, and there you will see all highlighted cryptocurrencies which you have highlighted. And by the way, guys, these which you are seeing right now here, this is just an example, as I added some, so you can see how your portfolio looks. Next one is CoinMarketCap, which you also know, guys, and here you can create a watch list and portfolios. And watch list is only if you would like to watch the list of some different cryptocurrencies without pretty much tracking a price. If you click here, guys, on watch list, I don't remember I have added here anything or not. As you can see, yes, I have added here for some examples. I have here four different cryptocurrencies which are added on my watch list. So here I can see 24 volume, whether they go up or whether they go down. However, maybe I haven't added them even to my portfolio. Like, let's go down and let's go back and let's add some cryptocurrency to my watch list. Let's say I would like to add Stellar to my watch list. You just click here on this star sign, or you can also click it whenever you are in open profile of particular cryptocurrency. And then I scroll up and go into my watch list, and Stellar will be also added there, similar to what we did with CoinGecko. As you see, Stellar is also added. But also, you can create your portfolio here, like on those applications which I showed you previously, just by clicking on to portfolio. And here, once you will be also logged in, obviously you will have to log in or create accounts to log in into CoinGecko or CoinMarketCap. Here you can create your portfolio, just click on it, and for example, you are holding whatever cryptocurrency, let's say CKB, which is Nervos Network, and let's say that you are your quantity, or you are holding, let's say 100,000 of them. Your price per coin, this is this price, guys, and this will be calculating from CoinMarketCap price, which is displayed on CoinMarketCap. So here you can see how much it is worth, 1,800 for 100,000 CKB, and add transaction. And all you will need to do is go back into CoinMarketCap now and click on your portfolio once again. And here you will see your portfolio and that this cryptocurrency CKB or Nervos Network will be added to your portfolio. As you can see here, guys, and this is similar kind of design like in Coinbase. And you can add many other different cryptocurrencies and track them here in your portfolio, also on CoinMarketCap. Guys. So yes, guys, these are the top applications, and I hope that you found this video useful. And if you did, leave a like, share this video, subscribe to my channel if you are new, and see you in the next one.